jump, Dominique. Can I not jump because it's like an overhang? I lost my jump! I can't jump anymore. I mean, you know, my special jump. That's unfortunate. I can't save, I can't jump. There's some stuff over here. I'm kind of wary about... scanning because... sometimes that crashes the game. And I don't want my game crashed. But at the same time, I want to find all the goodies. Alright, wants me to go on this. Wants me to go over there. The wasteland. That's 200 meters to go there. Let me go all the way over here. Regina's still hanging out. I guess this is something she would have told us about if she could speak. Am I gonna fight somebody else now? Plus blood type, mutilation from car accident, then asphyxiation. Bratsk U4020. This bad boy burns through as much fuel per hour as you'd need to heat an entire mega block, and let's face it, it's big and ugly as a mega block too. So can't jump. Archive conversations, Saul Bright and Amelia Weiss. Yeah. Amelia Weiss says, lost our transported parts for the new research center. Went missing on Aldecaldo turf. Saul Bright says, our meaning whose? Meaning Biotechnica's. But I'm making some private inquiries at the moment. We work on the same turf, but that doesn't mean we have to step on each other's toes. Saul says, not our problem. You're in the Badlands, and out here you stand to run into all sorts of gangs and threats. Maybe you should have chosen a quieter location for that new center. Amelia says, the nature of the research demands discretion. We need it done out of the way, as far out of the city as possible. If we were to hire someone to track down our cargo, how much would a job like that set us back? Saul says, well, considering the apparent value of the cargo, the price would be high. Amelia says, in euro dollars, please, and with a deadline. Like I said, the price would be high, and not just in euro dollars. We can get those with any contract out here. Amelia says, so what's your ask? Reverse transpiration zerophytes. But they're not ready for the market yet. Well, put them on the market. A prototype series, that is, unless you're in no hurry. Amelia says, you're right, a small prototype batch, but I can't guarantee they'll grow. They're still in the testing phase. They haven't even been planted outside of lab conditions. And what sort of deadline can I count on for the recovery of our cargo? Saul says, I'll start looking once those first buds bloom. Shouldn't be too long after. Can I save yet? Nope. Message Regina about Cyber Psycho sighting the wasteland. Okay. I can't. Wait. I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to complete this. You were almost right. Turns out it was a prisoner who went cyber psycho and managed to escape. Coincidentally, just happened to be one Aldecado, buddy of a prisoner I rescued from the same outfit. Managed to take him down gently. Well, that was unexpected. I'll relay this info to Dakota. Probably better if the family takes it from there. Quicker he gets back to familiar territory, the quicker he'll get back to normal. Saul was too valuable as a pawn, so it looks like they tried to beat as much useful intel out of this poor gonk and make Saul watch, hoping that he'd crack. Eventually, they took him for one of their rides through the desert to separate them, and that's when things got out of hand. He probably mistook you for one of them. Good thing you were able to save him. Thank you. Hopefully now. We can save? No. And Regina's still hanging out over here. We're stuck. I mean, what could possibly reset this? If we get into a fight with somebody else? I don't even know if that would do it. I'm running into cacti here. If it wasn't for my cyberware, it'd be extremely painful experience. Breaking no bread. Yeah, that's enough of that. We. I saw something over there. This thing's all over the place. Oh my god. Whoops. I guess that's just to protect the sign. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just trying to get away from here, so hopefully it resets. I'm on a rampage. Alright. I'm not going back there. I'm not buying that. We can go here, Merc needed. Oh wait, we can go here, assault in progress. I should be there and then there. I want my money and the double. I want my money and the double. My money and the double and the money and my double. What did I just hit? Come on, someone call me and reset this thing. Is this not where it is? Oh, it's close. It's not actually in this building. I don't even want to level up because I'm gonna have to level up again. I still can't jump. I can't open this door. My jumping power is gone, otherwise. It's a hard one. Yeah. Beware of the pipe. €46. Regina, go away. America, a prophecy. The Unification War for Gonks. €51. Stapler. Oh. Was there something over there? I thought I saw something. Never mind. Now we were what, like second or third floor? We were up here. I assume we'd be able to walk across this bridge. Whoops. Ural Combinat Locomotive. Technical specifications. Cargo locomotive. Manufacturer's Ural Combinat. Model AM773. Tear weight 200 tons, I'm guessing. Reactor count 2. Power 12,550 kilowatts. Max speed 70 miles an hour. A brake is a OEXX7B. Data transfer module stuff. Okay. Welcome aboard. Congratulations, you have just joined one of the 12 proud CORP-BUD locations. With your help, we will rebuild what the war left in rubble. With every bag of cement shipped, with every train car sent out, we are one step closer to reaching our goal. What's more, we're the only branch location with our own train car wash. That's right, you can even use it to clean your own vehicle. For your comfort and safety, we offer a complete sports and entertainment package as well as a the G-Rapid Detox and Relaxation Program. Note, for your own safety, please wear protective gear at all times while working. CORP-BUD is not responsible for improper use of workplace equipment or any adverse health effects that may result thereof, including but not limited to blood poisoning, toxic shock, or any instances of cyberpsychosis due to overuse of the G-Rapid program. Well, we've been duly debriefed about that then. Inside Meadow Corp. This all seems pertinent, so I'll read it. It's not long. We associate nomads with chaos, societal collapse, technological backwardness, and for good reason. There are always exceptions to the rule, and for the nomads, that exception is the Meta, more specifically Metacorp. Unlike other nomad groups that deal in smuggling and raiding, the Meta are strictly law-abiding. Metacorp, formerly registered in the Western corporate states, is a majority stakeholder in numerous shipping companies, including the rapidly growing DTR, Decker, Tanaka, and Rogers, which handled 53% of all America's transport last year. The story of Metacorp is a story of American entrepreneurial spirit and confidence in the future. Two things that not even a nuclear war could destroy. Indeed, Metacorp only proves that a new order can rise out of entropy, that the rustle of euro dollars is capable of civilizing even the most savage barbarians. Last month, I had an opportunity to visit the company's headquarters in Metakey, the mobile island currently anchored in the Gulf of Mexico. There, I met Victoria Meta. These people's last name? The corporation's nomad CEO and granddaughter of Metacorp founder, Jonathan Meta. Victoria had clearly inherited his steely gaze and enterprising mind. Well, that's good for her. The Undoing, Fall of the First Net. I'll read that another time. €16, breaking the bank here. Nobody up here at all? I'm wondering if it's supposed to be like that, or because... Oh, things are messed up here. Nomads for the thick-skinned. Got some computers we can read. 69, dudes. Euros, that is. 29. My gun randomly got put away. Pathology of the Badlands. Punch cards. Instructions. Can I read that? Thank you. Oh, that's pathology. Each position on the card, punched, unpunched, responds to a unit of information, while each column represents one character or symbol When gently inserting the card into the reader, please remember to do the following. Check for any damaged punch holes which may corrupt the reading. Make sure cards are inserted in proper order. Double check that a card description matches the data encoded on it. You don't really use punch cards? You gotta be kidding me. Well, let's see what this stuff is. Action cannot be performed during a call, so I can't do this stuff. Regina, go away. Because we're in a call. Stuff's not working. Back here, that was like, we're not auto-saving either. That was like about a half hour ago. 58:08, yeah, almost a half hour ago. I'm probably gonna have to play all this over again from the Cyber Psycho to this. So where's this bridge? Where's the rest of this? Wasn't there a bridge? Oh, we're above it. Oh, it really just goes over that. And then whatever's going on... has to do with these guys. How are they hitting me from there? Oh, I can't take... I can't take anything. I can't take anything. Oh, I'm gonna die. How are they even hitting me over these walls? Oh, now it works. This thing's all bugged out now. I would load a save, but that's a half hour ago. Critical. Hitting me from that way too. That one. Oops. Okay. I'm just missing now. Around that time. I thought I could zoom in better than that. I'm targeting the wrong thing here. Oh, no. That's it. Okay. Let's go check it out, I guess. And then we'll probably call it an episode after that, and then I'll have to play it over again. I'll come back and read the stuff for you off the computer monitors. And that's about it. I'm gonna have to play it over again. Because I can't save. Because we're stuck in a call. I wish I could force her to hang up. Oops. Be interesting if I come back and find this place full of criminals. So these people were up there on that ridge. So I wonder if they had anything to do with this. Like if they wanted to take it over or something like that. That was actually a waste. I could have taken food or something. But I'm gonna have to play this over again most likely anyway. Oops. I like that song. Archives conversation with Dylan Connell and Mandy Patrick. Dylan says, do you copy? Do you copy? What's the password? Manny says, birds fly in flocks. Error, error, incorrect password. Manny says in all caps, the bleep you say. Dylan says it's the wrong password. You either know how to play or you don't. You either know the pass or you don't. And if you don't know the pass, don't even start. Manny says, all right, whatever. The Aldecaldos are coming. Finally, how long has a chum got to wait? Chum has to wait that long. I can't get that. I'll check that last. Still don't have my jump. Sweet. I think that might be my next ride. Looks like there's nothing else here. Wait. Yeah. Get Mr. Nowacki. Nowacki. Get to work, gonks. Aldecaldos are up to something, hanging around the station. Gonna have some job brewing. I want to see what it is, see if I can make some eds off of it. You all go there and keep tabs on the situation. Once you figure out what's what, give me a ring, okay? Okie dokie. Well, that's the end of that. Well, we have more stuff. We have this, and we have this. Rescue the person, an assault in progress. But next episode, I'm actually going to be... Yeah, I want to hear what she has to say about this cyber psycho. I'll fight him off screen and collect all the stuff, same as always, and I'll go up into the, I guess, a train station there. The control center or whatever. We can read any messages on the computer. That's assuming the same bug with Regina doesn't happen every time. A scary thought. And then if anything new, yeah, I'll show you guys. Otherwise, you'll be taking care of these two things next. And then we might just head on to these things. Maybe that, and then we'll head back and do the rest of these few things. It'll take a few episodes. I gotta level up, too. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Regina bids you farewell. And always, seek adventure.